Noise coming, I think. Your voice is not audible. Is it, sir? Voice is not audible. Sir, your voice is not audible, sir.
Odisha Young Technocrat Award, and he is also a J2EE and data science consultant and has designed and developed various software applications for learning IT companies.
Sir, actually, Abhijit sir, so sir, Abhijit sir, can I interrupt it? Abhijit sir. Sir, Abhijit, sir. Sir, actually, your voice is not audible, sir. There are so many noise arising from outside.
Hello.
Professor Mandal, your voice is not audible.
Hello. Am I audible?
I think say a record person to the conversation now. I was good.
Am I audible?
You're audible now.
Okay. So next speaker, Dr. Gunil Balwandrai, B.Tech, M.Tech, PhD in CSE, and he's working as an assistant professor in NIT Meghalaya. His research includes on robotics, image processing, biomedical image analysis, and cybersecurity. He has published 13 papers in national and biomedical image and international journals. So currently, he is working on design and development of intelligent algorithm for analysis and detection of content and forgery. The image available in the social media platform, and it is under the Cybercrime Prevention Against Women and Children Scheme of Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India. We welcome you. Currently, he is working as a data analyst scientist at Milan Software Private Limited. He is having first practical experience in analyzing, developing, and implementing data projects to meet customer expectations. Data science, artificial intelligence, and the power we are using in the field of data science. We welcome Dr. Mangra. Now, let me give you the brief idea about this webinar topic.
that as we know that we are very familiar with machine learning, and we know machine learning is a method of data analysis which automates analytical model building, and basically it is a branch of from the data and identify patterns and make decisions with minimal human intervention. Similarly, if we say about the deep learning, it is a subfield of machine learning concerned with algorithms, which is inspired by the structure and function of the brain, called the artificial neural system. Basically, the open source or the open source computer vision library. And this library basically optimizes state of both plastic and state of the art computer vision. You will discover that what type of open
source is. Actually, sir, Abhijit sir.
Yes.
So actually, voice is completely breaking actually, and I think maybe some network issue is going on from your side, and so many noises are also arising from outside. I think what I am observing last couple of times that I have been saying. So I think some problem is going on, I think.
Okay, okay.
So this record portion, I think it so it is coming. So I am not getting actually what you were saying from the beginning, and so currently, so your voice is completely not audible, actually.
Okay, okay. So let me just check out. Dr. Jung, can you check, please?
भाई देख स्लो हो जाए बहुत दिन पर भाई टे देख ली दर्शन टिके हला आओ कम है मोटा मोटी हिलो नहीं ଭଲ ଖିଆ ପିଆ ହେଉଛି ସେପଟରେ, ଭଲ ଟିକେ ବୋଧେ ଭେଜିଟେବଲ ଭଲ ଖାଦ୍ୟପେୟ ମିଳୁଛି ବୋଧେ ଆଉ।
I think I request all of you not to speak personal things because the participants are online. Please.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sorry, sir.
Abhijit, Abhijit, are you there? Mr. Tilochan, what I suggest that why don't you start your talk?
Okay, not so actually we yes sir, actually I have waited the response from Abhijit sir. If you are telling that we can start, there is
doesn't matter. What I request that please proceed. You give yourself introduction and then please proceed. Let us don't waste time.
Okay, sir. Not an issue. So very good afternoon to all of you. So first point is so can you give a response? My voice is audible to all of you? Yes
Your
or
voice no? is audible. Very nice. Please proceed.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So first of all, on behalf of Silam Software Private Limited, giving a special thanks to the director sir, management team, especially Abhijit sir, so giving a chance to us for associating with you. So first of all, giving a special thanks, and all the participants also, I am giving lots of thanks. So you all have participated. So in this context, so my name is Trilochan Torai, and working as CEO at Silam Software Private Limited. So basically, I am a Java and data science expert. So today, so as per the discussion of Abhijit sir and me, and we decided the topic will that we have given the name, that is OpenCV in Deep Learning. So first of all, what is my agenda? So that I want to give the clarity first. So first of all, what we have to know. So my screen is it is visible to all of you?
Oh, we cannot see your screen.
Yes, I am sharing. Okay. So now it is visible. Now my screen is visible.
Yes, you are
visible. Okay, thank you. So first of all, our agenda is, today's agenda is, first of all, we will discuss what is computer vision. What is computer vision? Then how a computer reads an image. What is OpenCV? Some basics of OpenCV. And image detection using OpenCV. This is our agenda today. So I hope you all have aware about artificial intelligence. Nowadays, it is the age of artificial intelligence. If
we will see every segment, if we will see every field, software field, retail field, bank industry, any industry, if you will see the concept of artificial intelligence widely used, and I hope you all have acquired little bit knowledge, everybody have. Artificially, we are generating a model. Basically, that model we are considering as a machine. Then once the model we are generating, then after that, we are giving the training to that model. That means the model is becoming trained. So once the model is trained, we are saying the model is becoming intelligent. Once the model is becoming intelligent, then whatever we have the task, then the model is resolving. So that's why the term have come, that is artificial intelligence. Then machine learning and deep learning, because today's topic is OpenCV in deep learning. So my point is, first of all, we have to know what is artificial intelligence, and machine learning and deep learning are two approaches, are two techniques to achieve artificial intelligence. So if I will say this is artificial intelligence, we can say machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence, or deep learning is a subset of artificial intelligence, or we can say machine learning and deep learning are two techniques to achieve artificial intelligence. So basically, whatever we are generating the model, that model we are saying that is machine. Then lots of tasks we resolved using machine learning. Then lots of tasks, so that is not possible that we can implement. We can implement machine learning to resolve a task. For example, basically what we faced the problem, particularly some examples like image processing, detecting an object in a motion video, NLP, natural language processing. So particularly in this field, in this era, when some task, some tedious, some complex task, when it is coming to our picture, then when we implemented the concept of machine learning, we faced some difficulties. So that's why again the concept of deep learning came to our picture. So in deep learning, so beautiful, beautiful concept that we studied. Some libraries, come to our picture, like TensorFlow, like our OpenCV, now the today's topic, then NLTK for NLP. So many libraries developed, and that libraries are Python libraries, because Python, why nowadays Python is becoming popular only due to this libraries. Because whatever the current libraries that we are studying, we are implementing, all the libraries are Python libraries. Similarly, OpenCV is one of the libraries. So what is the meaning of OpenCV, open source computer vision? So first of all, we have to know what is a computer vision. And OpenCV is a library. It is a software library. Somebody have developed, some organization have developed. Basically, library means what in our context? Library means some, it is containing some built-in functions. Varieties of built-in functions are available. Library means a container. Basically, in other programming language, we can say it is a package. In Python, we are saying that is a module. That means so many built-in functions that already that is available in OpenCV, and that built-in function we will use to resolve our task. And every built-in function having a specific functionality, having a specific purpose, that we will see. Okay, so first of all, we will come to our point. So what do you mean by computer vision? So computer vision, suppose nowadays one scenario that I am saying, suppose everybody is using Facebook. Suppose I am posting so many photos in Facebook. So Facebook is suggesting. So when the Facebook, I am posting some photos, Facebook is suggesting for tagging. Facebook is saying, so can you tag to these people's? Okay, so this is the vision of a computer. So it is, we can say it is a field. It is an interdisciplinary field. So we can say it is a sub-field of artificial intelligence. And AI enables our computer system to think something. But when the computer vision is a such thing, when we implement, it will think about some steps additionally that computer vision is thinking. Suppose AI is enabling a computer to think something about a picture, whereas a computer vision is thinking to process the picture, to process, to manipulate something from a digital image or videos. So this is called as a vision. So this overall, that representing computer vision. Okay, so I hope everybody got clarity. If any question will arise, so without any fail, anybody can ask. So if I will define a computer vision in a full manner, so it is a field, or it is an interdisciplinary field of artificial intelligence. So where AI, which enables computers and system to derive meaningful information from digital images and videos and other visual inputs. For example, image processing. For example, suppose I will create a video, or I will play a video. From a video, I will detect an object, detecting an object from a video. So if this type of applications coming to our picture, then we will implement the concept of computer vision to resolve the task. So lots of ways that we can resolve using also CNN, convolutional neural network and deep learning. There is also another approach to process the image. But when the concept of videos and in a very clarity manner, less code, if you want to write, and easily understandable, portable, everybody should understand what you are writing the source code for resolving a task, that is nothing but computer vision source code. So I hope everybody got clarity what is computer vision. Then another point is, before going to that, first of all, I want to tell what is my environment. First of all, in which environment I will work? My environment is Jupyter Notebook. Jupyter Notebook, then there are lots of environments that we can develop and execute our source code. But the very suitable environment, what I have observed, what I have felt, that is Jupyter Notebook. And that Jupyter Notebook that I have got by installing Anaconda. Just little bit information, just I am telling. By installing Anaconda, that I have got Jupyter Notebook. Okay, so first of all, so just I will open my Jupyter Notebook. Just this is my Jupyter Notebook. If I will close all these things, so how I will open my Jupyter Notebook once Anaconda software you have installed, and after that Jupyter Notebook once you have launched in, you go to search button, just to type JU, just automatically an option is coming, that is Jupyter Notebook. So just I clicked. So now my environment that I am opening, and my environment, my integrated development environment, that is Jupyter Notebook. In my, this is the field where I will develop, or where I will write some OpenCV code for resolving a task. So guys, this is my Jupyter Notebook homepage. This is my homepage. Okay, so now I will create a new file. Just to see, there is an option, new option. Just I clicked, then automatically an option is coming, Python 3. So now I click this, that's I got a new file. So this is my new Python file where I will develop and execute my OpenCV source code. Just you see, there is an option on title. Just I clicked here, I will give a file name. Whatever the file name you will give, that is completely user defined. That depend upon you, whatever you give. Suppose I will give Python OpenCV tutorial, whatever I will write. Now I will click rename. So this is my new file. So in this or here or in this new file, I will write my OpenCV source code. Whatever we have the test, the code will resolve. So I hope everybody got clarity. Give a response. So I hope everybody is getting clarity, whatever I am saying. So can you give a response? I hope everybody is getting clarity. Can you give a response? Yes or no?
Hello, Mr. Tarai. Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Your voice is audible.
So please continue with your presentation, and the question session answer session will be in the last.
So then my point is, my second point is how a computer reads an image, particularly in deep learning context or in AI context, how a computer reads an image. And you remember every image converting. Now I will show you. We will take an image and how the control is understanding the image. So you remember there is a library. So actually before going to machine learning or AI, so so many libraries are here. Pandas, NumPy, so Matplotlib. These are basic libraries, Matplotlib, Seaborn. So here I am telling about NumPy library. So NumPy already available inside the OpenCV. Okay, I will come to what is OpenCV. Completely OpenCV is a library and specifically used for computer vision. So NumPy library already available inside the OpenCV. What is NumPy? NumPy meant for array. NumPy is a such library. That library we use to generate one dimensional or multi-dimensional array. So when an image we are inputting, how the control is understanding? The control is understanding an image as 2D or 3D array, or you can say matrix. So two dimensional or three dimensional array, the array taking two subscript, that is we can say that is two dimensional, this is subscript, two dimensional, otherwise three subscript, that is three dimensional. So first of all, we have two types of image. One is black and white image. Basically, we can say that is grayscale image. Basically, this image is called as black and white image. And another image is colored image. So colored image. So colored, how the control understanding. What a grayscale image, in which way and how the control is understanding grayscale image? First of all, little bit information that we have to know. So black and white image, it is nothing but a NumPy array. So NumPy array, I will show you. Then when the concept of colored image, suppose array means what it is, if array, that is nothing but a in the form of matrix. Matrix means number of rows and number of columns. Okay, so we know an image means it is nothing but what collection of pixel, and particularly here in our context, each pixel, an image consisting of pixels, where each pixel value ranging from 0 to 255. You have to remember some, this is the basic terminologies that we have to know. So again, I'm saying an image two category. One is black and white image, or that is called as grayscale image, and one is colored image. So black and white image, so converted internally into two-dimensional array or 2D matrix. Whereas colored image, that array converted, suppose let it we have 600 number of rows, 600 number of rows and 700 columns, suppose an image, then there is an additional point I am writing into three. So what the three representing? This three representing a color channel. This channel is, that is RGB, that is R, G and V, red, green, blue. So there is a color palette or there is a color channel for the colored image RGB. So I will show you how the control is understanding an image, how the control is understanding black and white image and colored image. So colored image into three, one additional point control is adding that colored channel value. So overall colored channel that have all identified, that is by, or that is nothing but RGB, red, green, blue, and an image is nothing but what, collection of pixels where each pixel value ranging from 0 to 255. Suppose I have an image, that image is suppose let it 6 cross 6 or 3 cross 3. Suppose let it one, we have a black and white image. Suppose I will write, suppose 3 cross 3, suppose let it 120, 40, this is 50, this is 70, suppose this is 75, this is 80, this is 90, suppose. That means these are the pixel values. Suppose an image is nothing but a 3 cross 3 matrix. So here, these are the pixel value. One pixel, each pixel, the value is ranging from 0 to 255. So this is the point, or in this way, the control is understanding, or we can say the computer reads an image in this way. Okay, so there are two images, black and white image, colored image. Every image control understand it is an array. In Python, there is no concept of array. When the library came, when the library NumPy came to the picture, came to the market, then through NumPy, we created array. One dimensional, two dimensional, three dimensional, or multi-dimensional array we created. So image converting into NumPy array. Then we will see what is OpenCV, then we will come to our point. So OpenCV, I can write OpenCV is a library, is a software library, is a software library specifically used for computer vision. So we will see what is my computer vision, face detection, detecting an object in a motion video, mask detection. So we can say these are one example or one era of computer vision. So OpenCV library we will use, okay, to resolve these tasks. So this is all about fundamental points about OpenCV. So first of all, so I hope everybody got clarity. First of all, we will go to OpenCV. The question is, since it is a library, we have to install, how to install OpenCV. So since it is a software library, first we have to install. So once this library is installed, then so many built-in functions that we can get So inside the OpenCV and that built-in function, we will use to resolve our task. So you go through Anaconda command front. Basically what we are using, any command front, if you will go, there is no problem. Basically, we have used Anaconda command front. Already we have installed. Just I will show you. Just you go to Anaconda command prompt. In search button, in search once you have installed Anaconda, and then we have a basically I have a tutorial site, ceylontutorial.com. This is my site that already I have developed. So you go through Python just to see how to install Anaconda and get Jupyter Notebook. So here, this is completely our site. So here I have written, I have specified how to install Anaconda software, very simple. And how we will get Jupyter Notebook through Anaconda. So once you have Anaconda software, in search button, simply you type AN, automatically Anaconda command prompt will come. Just you click, so you go through Anaconda command prompt. Suppose I will write, you go through a C drive, then simply you type a command. You remember pip install, pip install opencv hyphen python, hyphen python. So the, you remember, this is the command for installing opencv. So you open, you go through command prompt, simply you type this command pip install, then opencv hyphen python, you enter. Once you will enter, within few seconds it will install. So already I have installed, so there is no need that I will install. Already I have this opencv module. So now once you have opencv, or once you will install opencv, then how you will know your opencv library that you have installed successfully? So how you will know? So first of all, the library we have to brought, we have to brought into our environment, into our Jupyter Notebook environment. So that is called as importing. So import means bringing, export means sending. So first of all, we have to import OpenCV library. So OpenCV is a library that we have to install first. Once we will install successfully, then we will bring that OpenCV software into our environment. So that is called as importing. So what I am writing, just to see what I am writing, import CV2. You remember the module name is CV2. You remember the module means a container, or you can say it is a package. Okay, or you can say it is a library. So why we are going to our library? Every college having library. Because we are thinking, if we are going to our library, so many books are available as per our requirement. So that's why we are going to the library. That means a library is a such place where varieties of books are available as per the our requirement. Similarly, CV2 is a library. It is a module where it contains so many built-in functions as per our requirement. Our requirement is to resolve the task, computer vision related task. So now I will hit run. So here in Jupyter Notebook, execution is very simple. So there is a run option. Simply you will hit run. So now I imported. If no error is arising, that means happily CV2 imported. So just I can give the comment to describe this. Import OpenCV library, import OpenCV module. So I can write in this way. Okay. So happily the library I imported. So how I am importing OpenCV? So that is CV2. So import is a keyword. So we can say this is an import statement. Now I will print the current version. So to get the current version of OpenCV, So that is, so I can write, print, okay, cv2 dot, remember, double underscore version, double underscore. Suppose since it is a software library, somebody have developed, some organization have developed. So if you will go through, if you will go through Google and you type OpenCV, just to see here, you can see the Wikipedia. OpenCV is a library of programming functions mainly aimed at real-time computer vision. Originally developed by Intel, it was later supported by Willow Garage, then it says. So you can see also the history of OpenCV library, and Intel Corporation, that means the organization have developed what? OpenCV. So if I, since it is a software library, so I can get the latest version of OpenCV. Now I will hit wrong. Just to see what the output we are getting, that is 4.4.0. Okay, so the latest version of OpenCV is, that is 4.4.0. Now directly we will go to some basics of OpenCV. That means how the control read, how we will read an image. Okay, suppose in my E drive, some images, suppose I have kept in my E drive. Suppose there is a folder, I think there is a Ceylon folder. Here some image, suppose American image, some image here I have kept. So some images I have kept. So now that image, how I will read? So directly, you can identify the path name, just I am showing. So how to question is, how to read and display an image. Okay, so for this, there is a function, that function name is I am read function. This function coming from CV2, so that's why it is invoking by CV2. So that's why I wrote CV2 dot IamRead function, and within this, the file name, whatever the picture file, something dot JPG, Amir dot JPG, SRK dot JPG, or Silu dot JPG, some file name I will write. That file also here, you can bring, there is an option upload directly. Suppose I selected Amir, now I will click open, then there is an option upload. Now Amir.jpg uploaded in your environment. Amir.jpg, now it is uploaded. So in this way also, directly the file you can bring to your Jupyter notebook environment by uploading. Okay, otherwise directly E drive /Ceylon/ exact path name you have to specify. Suppose here directly, so I uploaded the file. Suppose that file name, suppose I have file name, that is, suppose silu.jpg. Okay, silu, otherwise Amir, currently I uploaded Amir.jpg. AMIR, okay, file name is AMIR, Amir.jpg, comma, then a zero. I am read function taking two parameter, one is name of the file and another is either zero or one you have to specify. Strictly speaking, you remember, zero meant for black and white image or grayscale image, whereas one meant for your colored image. Just to see, now this I am read function using or by invoking IAM read function, just one image I brought into my environment or that image we will read. Now the image, suppose I will assign in a variable, let the variable name is img. Suppose let my variable name is img. Suppose let it. So now I will print what is the value of image. Now I will print. So what I did, again I'm saying there is a built-in function. The built-in function name is imread function, just it is invoking by CV2. Then this function returns an image. That image, suppose I assigned in a variable, let the variable name is img. So now I will write the output statement print img. Now I will hit run. Just to see, I got a two-dimensional array. This is a two-dimensional array. This is the two-dimensional array. And all are the pixel values. All are the pixel values. Then you know how you will know how many number of rows and how many number of columns. So that I will write one output statement. img dot, there is a keyword. Safe is a keyword. Now I will hit run just to see what I got. The output 608 and 612. That means, so currently I told every image is nothing but an array, 2D array or 3D array. Since I have specified the value 0 in parameter, so that representing a black and white image. Then I will use one. I will come to that point. So in this array, 608 number of rows and 612 number of columns. Maybe question may arise, sir, how you will know it is an array? So you can see the type of the variable img. So you can see print. So what is the type? There is a function, type function. Type function, I can write img. Now I will hit run. Just to see what I got the output, numpy.nd array. So this, that means what it representing. So your img is nothing but a numpy array. So img contains our image. That image is American image. So that image is nothing but a numpy array. Numpy array. Suppose instead of 0, suppose if I will write 1 instead of 0, if I will write 1, then what the output is coming to our picture and what we are observing. Just you see, one, what I told currently, one mintif for colored image, 0 mintif for black and white image. Now I will hit run. Just to see, three-dimensional, already as I have told, the array taking three subscripts. It is ending three subscripts. Taking three subscripts, that is three-dimensional array. And you see, this is the RGB value. RGB color channel value. And only that RGB value is coming to the picture, but it is a three-dimensional array. And just you see, the size is same size, 608 number of rows, 612 number of columns, comma 3. 3 representing RGB, that is our colored channel. And here, last is I have written type of img. The type of img is, it is a numpy array. So I hope everybody got clarity. So in this way, how the control, or the control is understanding the image. Now I want to display our image. I want to display our image. So I will write, so this is the understanding of image by the control. So overall, currently what we observed, an image is nothing but a two-dimensional array or three-dimensional array. Then there is how to read an image. So there is a built-in function named as imread function. And when that imread function invoking by CV2, then an image is reading by the control. Now I want to display that image. So for displaying that image, so there is a function, imso function. All are built-in function, imread function, So function all are coming from OpenCV, that's why it is invoking YCV2. So I can write, so what the IAMSO function taking parameter? Parameter is, so two parameter, one parameter is name of the window. So anything I can write, so suppose I will write, this is, I wrote result. Result is completely user defined. Instead of result, you can write Ramadamasamo, whatever, you, there is no problem. So IAMSO function is a such function taking two parameter, one is
name.
Yes.
Sir, actually we are running out webinar. So as we have any other two resource persons are there, so if you allow us to, we could able to call them.
Sir, I cannot understand, sir. Sir, again, sir.
Actually, we have very limited time.
Okay. So, very soon, I am hand over. Just fundamental thing. Yes. Sir, after after taking 5 minutes, just I am handovering another resource. Okay.
Please,
want to show an image. So IAMSO function taking two parameters. One is name of the window. Let it name of the window. I wrote result. Result is completely user defined and the variable where image have assigned. So here my variable name is img. Okay, then after, so when it will call, then an image will display. So when image will display, so how it will quit, how it will remove. So there is a function. So this function, we have to know that the wait key function. Suppose in wait key function, suppose I have written, I specified 0. Speedily I am saying, so 0 means once an image is coming to our picture, then any key in my keyword, any key I will enter, that will automatically remove. And whatever the all the windows associated for displaying an image, if I want to release the, all these things, so there is a function destroy all windows. Destroy all windows function, and this is the built-in function, completely all windows will release. Now I will hit run. Just to see this American picture came. So this is called as how to display an image. So now I will press any key I will press. Now any key I pressed, it removed. So that is the objective of wait key function. Okay, so first of all, this is the fundamental thing that we have to know before entering to a task. Okay, so guys, actually I have another task actually. When next time I will get, then I will explain very neat and cleanly how to detect a face of a human being. So face detection. Okay, now our team member Rasmi Ranjan, he is data scientist at Ceylon Software Private Limited, and my friend Bunil Balavantarai, Dr. Bunil Balavantarai, assistant professor at NIT Meghalaya. So he is also in our panel. So now I would like to invite to Rasmi Ranjan Mangraj. So he will deliver the remaining the points and one project as soon as possible. He will explain in neat and clean manner. So thank you to all of you.
Hi, good afternoon to all.
Yes.
Sir, mute your device. Yes, please.
Hello, everyone. So this is Rasmi Ranjan Mangraj. Currently working as a data scientist at Ceylon Software. So as sir has handover to me, so I will show you a small project on hand tracking using OpenCV. So you can see here I am using a Visual Studio Code IDE. This is another IDE for using Python code. Okay, I'm going to share my screen. So is my screen visible now?
Yes, it's visible.
Okay, thank you. So as you've told, there's not enough much time to explain all the codes. So I'm just running the code and showing you what the actually the output is. So I just need to run the code by Python. The code name is hand-track.py. The PY is the extension for Python program in Visual Studio Code. In Jupyter Notebook, it is IPYNB, which is IPython Notebook. But in Visual Studio Code, it is .py extension. So I need to just hit the enter button. So it will take just wait for a few seconds. It will just take some time. So you can see here, my hand is getting dragged. Everybody can see? Please give a response. Hello.
Yeah, hello.
Yes,
that's
sir.
Visible.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So in this period, I have just used some libraries like MediaPipe and OpenCV to hand track my project. So I will hit just the escape button. And this is my project. And if you let me, I can explain a few terms just related to this project. I have used a MediaPipe library. It is a vast library which contains lots of ML solutions. ML solutions related to OpenCV projects like face detection, object detection, your object tracking. So everything is there. You just need to import this library and use the inbuilt functions which are related to this library only. So what are the inbuilt functions like drawing utils, solution, hands. So everything is there. So how the developer has developed this, I'm showing you an image. So this is the image you can see here. All the points has been tracked by the developer. So around 30,000 images has been used in this project. 30,000, and we are just coding this and getting the output. Sir, if you let me, I can explain some terms also. So few terms are like multi-hand landmarks. So this is the main function which contains all the landmarks or landmark points of the hand. And hand connections. So these connection helps the connecting the points that have been generated through deep learning procedure. To connect the points, we have used hand connections. This is actually Z, and I can show you if I change the color here to 255. In OpenCV, it reads as BGR, blue, green, red. So I have given the value of 255 at the red channel. So it is going to show me a red color dot. So let's just see. Python handtrack.py. So now it's showing a red color. Everybody can see?
Yes.
If I also give two hands, it is also going to show you two hands. So I am also going to show you another project, just a brief introduction of that project I am giving you. It's called pose estimation. So I have used a video file here. So I just need to activate my virtual environment. It is activate keyboard and open cv-python. Sorry, hyphen env. So to run the program, python pose underscore estimate dot py. This is my file name. I just need to hit the enter button. So now it's visible or not? The video is being played and the motions have been tracked. Everybody can see this? This is actually a 2-minute video, so this much is enough. Okay, and now I am handing over this session to Trilochan sir. Trilochan sir, you can continue now.
Rashmi, thanks a ton. I will hand over to Bunil sir. Bunil sir, my voice is audible. Bunil sir.
Yes.
So guys, so on behalf of Ceylon Software Private Limited, Dr. Bunil Balavant Rai, vast experienced in the field of academics. So now I would like to Dr. Bunil, he will deliver regarding this context. So please, Bunil sir.
Yeah, thank you, Trilochan. Let me share my screen. Is my screen visible, Trilochan?
So,
sir, it's visible.
Yeah, it's processing.
So, please open your PPT or.
So that is I think process is going on. I think. Yes, the picture came.
Okay, let me talk to the participants. I hope all of you know about the basic concept of data, right? Data processing, all these. As my research group is working on this machine learning and deep learning concept, whatever Tilochan and his team have discussed, I'll show you the some of the basic concept of machine learning and also we say deep learning and how we can utilize it in different research dimension, right? In the presentations, I may refer to some of the concept which I will be skipping because it's a project copyright is there with the Ministry of Home Affairs, so I'll not be showing that part. But definitely, I'll be so giving you the brief technical content, how we can go for utilizing such concepts into the different projects. See, as the participant is concerned, what I know from a visit mandal, that they are from different system MBA background or something, some of them are from engineering background also. Let me go to the basic part, machine intelligence. Here, once artificial intelligence, we say, let me tell you one example. Whenever artificial intelligence we consider, considering one example, mango is ripe. Whenever you are going to market and we judge whether mango is ripe or not, and we'll choose only that ripe mangoes, right, to take home. So how do you check? How do you know that that mango is ripe, that mango is not ripe? So in a common sense, if the mango color is yellow, then we say it is ripe. That's in a common attitude we have, right? And some people also, because sometimes we fail by taking the color, yellow color mangoes, and it is not at all ripe. So what we do gradually, we thought of changing our perception, that we touch the mango, if there is a softness, right? So we consider that is ripe or not, right? So that these are the concepts we generally take into account in computing platforms. So this basic example, we convert it into a rule-based form. So what is a rule-based form here? Just like I'll be considering a sentence, mango is given to us. Some mangoes are having different colors. Some are having red, yellow, and some are having also green. So what are given? The premises is mango color, the color of the mango is yellow. The rule I need to consider also here, if the color of the mango is yellow, then it is ripe. So two things is given to me. Two things are given, that is the premise is the color of the mango is yellow. Second is the rule. If the color of the mango is yellow, then it is ripe. So what I understand from this particular concept, this particular two inputs, what I am going to get, right? The conclusion I can draw from this particular two inputs is the mango which is given to me are ripe, because the color of the mango is yellow is given. And the rule is, if the color of the mango is yellow, then it is certain, right? Right? So we need to draw this kind of conclusion. That means we need to predict. So machine intelligence is a kind of prediction system, we can say. And the new concept people are talking about, data analytics, it was there previously, but it is a name given, right, floated into the market so that people will aware of there is a new field, right? So whenever the researchers, they started doing research before, right? They are playing with the data. Similarly, nowadays also, they are playing with the data. But now, this machine learning or deep learning, they are more, you can say, a good player in the data analytics concept, because they are data hungry models. That means we can say they are certain kind of mathematical model. We give certain input as data, right? And we are expecting certain desired result. So if there is a large volume of data, then we can expect the such models, they can behave in an accurate sense. So that's why this topic I say is a machine intelligence. That means we are making the system intelligent enough to predict accurate result. So in my discussion, I may ask the organizer how much time it is available to me. How much time is available to me?
Yeah, it's okay, sir. Please continue.
Okay.
Hello.
So, I am asking because I don't really
like to put things into
picture. So machine learning. So in my discussion, I'll be talking about machine learning, some basic concept of machine learning and how it differs from deep learning, and different models of these particular criteria, these particular machine intelligence, right? So here, what is a cat? So as a human being, you can easily observe the different features or characteristics cat is having. And we record that, and we store that. That where we store, that we say is a knowledge base. So whenever an animal which is coming, new animal is coming to us, then we are going to check with our knowledge base that which category of this animal is. Then we'll predict this is a cat or this is a lion or this is something different. So that kind of prediction is also every human being is familiar with. But how the machine will understand? So the machine, we can put certain input, that is the data. That we say nowadays is the data analytics. So we need to extract the features, we need to extract the different characteristics of cat, dog, every animals, whatever you are going to consider in your example. So that you need to extract the different features, all possible features, and you need to store it in your system. Then whenever a new animal is coming to you and you are going to analyze that which kind of animal it is, or which category, that means you are going to classify. So what you are going to do, a new animal is coming, you are extracting that animal's features and some features you have already in your knowledge base. Then you are going to compare. So this comparison result, we suppose say you have cat features, you have lion features, you have dog features. So if any comparison gives more accurate, then you can go for that this is cat or this is dog or this is something lion. So that accuracy you need to find out using this machine intelligence concept. So these are the different varieties of cat. Because we are considering the computer vision, so that's why I'm putting the examples of computer vision. Here some portions of the cat is not properly visible. Here there's something different gesture of the cat, right? It is available in some part of the world. And this is a deformation. That means I change the particular image, right? So I transform the image, right? By adding different kind of varieties of noises. And there is a lighting variations. So due to different disorderness in the image which I capture, due to that, what I'm going to get? I'm going to get different varieties of images. So which creates a lot of problem in perceiving that which variety of animal it is going to be. So that prediction is going to be very difficult. So that's why machine intelligence is coming into effect. So what we'll do, we'll process and process. That means we'll fine-tune different parameters which are available with us with the new input, right? Then we'll go on predicting or finding out which is going to be more accurate, right? So These are the different varieties of research dimensions, right? In image processing, or you can say in computer research. So in machine learning, what we are going to understand is a basic machine learning is programming computers to optimize the performance criterion using the example data or passwords. Just like in nowadays, COVID is there, right? So whenever there is a lockdown situation, some days people are the particular authority is opening the market. So what we are doing, we are thinking if I go in the morning hour, the market will be lost, right? But if I go after 2-3 hours, right, or after 4 hours, or in the last hour, right? So it is our prediction that which hour is not lost in the market. So that prediction, how can I get? That is from the past experience. So that past experience is giving us the idea that which time is preferable to go into the market where the loss will not be out there, right? So this is a kind of machine learning. That means if you consider you are a machine, then you are learning, right, from your experience. So that is the similarly, the machine also is going to learn from the experience. That means the data which are available in the past. Similarly, there are different definitions available. I'm not going to that because all of you know. Now, coming to one very important example, because all of you are students, whenever there is a birthday party, right, or some friends are gathered and they wanted to go out, right, for outing. There are different varieties of illusion is there. Why I'll go for? What is the reason behind to go out? Suppose say, if I'll go for, suppose say one friend will tell, hey, hello, something you will go and take some food outside. Then some friend will suggest, let us go to hotel 1 or hotel 2 or hotel 3. That means there are varieties of suggestions will come from the friends. So suppose the friend 1 suggests hotel 1. Why hotel 1? The quality, maybe the quality of the food is good. Why hotel 2 by the friend 2? Maybe the gesture, the environment of the hotel is good, irrespective of the food quality, right? So there are different aspects of considering or choosing a particular hotel whenever you are thinking to go out, take certain food, right? And some friends may suggest, we'll go to that hotel where we can spend very good time, right? Where you can have a good space, which will not be that much rush. So that kind of peculiar behavior of data which we are going to collect, or which people are suggesting whenever we are going to take a decision, that peculiar data which is available to us, is, sometimes it is very difficult to take a decision, proper decision. So that's why machine is there to predict which will be best, which will be the best decision we can take for. So that is the different aspect we need, why we go for this machine intelligence concept. There is another example which I'm working currently, the image forgeries or different obscene information which are available in social media. Nowadays, I think all of you may have the idea or data, during this lockdown period, the cyber frauds are increasing like anything. And it is very high, that means 65% is increasing in India. And due to this cyber fraud, there are more number of casualties, right, death occurring in India. So how to check, how to give a checkmate to this kind of situations? So for that, my project, which I'm working with the Ministry of Home Affairs, I need to say, this is we are developing a software. That's basically, we are developing through Python programming and the computer vision concept we are employing, along with this machine intelligence concept. So what we need to do, we need to go for checking what kind of forgery available. That means if the people who are doing the forgery, we should know that what varieties of forgery may be possible. Then, that means if this data is not available to us, then I cannot develop an algorithm which can give a checkmate to this kind of situation. So that is required, that what are the techniques available, what are the varieties of forgery available to make certain things forgery. So in that case, what we do, we need to process a particular data, that means image data. As already Trilochan told something about how to give input, how to get output. That's a basic thing, but whenever it is image processing or computer vision task, you need to put data, that image data to the machine or to the model, not machine here, the model. Here, the machine learning algorithms or machine learning models are sufficient enough to extract the features. Whenever you talk about the conventional methods which are available before this kind of concept, at that moment, we are employing the conventional algorithm to extract the features separately. But whenever this kind of machine learning or deep learning concept is coming, these models are self-sufficient. They can extract the features, they can process it, they can classify it. That is everything you can say is available in the model. But these models are black box model. Black box means what is going on inside we are unaware of it. So nowadays there is a new concept which is going to come, and people are doing research on that, right? Explainable AI. That means where you can know what is going on inside a particular model, right? So there are different applications of this particular machine learning algorithms, varieties of applications, be it data processing, be it e-commerce, be it search engine development, anything you can talk about, collaborative tutoring, robotics, everything, right? So everywhere you can make use of it. Now, already I have told some examples. I'm just speaking this. Yes. There are three varieties of learning we need to understand, because as it is a machine learning, the term it is said, we need to give proper training to the machine. So there are the varieties of learning concept. Out of that, there are three important learning: one is supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement learning. So supervised learning, what we have, is this a cat or dog? That means we need to understand. So it is going to learn through different examples which is given to you. So it is being supervised by the teachers, right? Suppose at the childhood days, how to put the lace, right? How to put the books in the bag. So everything is being trained or is being guided by your parents. That is, we say it is a supervised learning. Similarly, predicting the market values, right, of a house in a particular locality, that's also supervised. So here, there are different concepts. Just like one example I need to showcase here. But how is the weather today? Suppose one person is working in an organization, and is going to leave the office by 5 p.m. Right, and he has a plan. After leaving the office, he go to the supermarket, purchase certain things. But whenever the time is reaching that he has to go, he has to leave the office, he has to think of the weather. If the weather condition is good, then he can think of going to the supermarket. If the weather condition is not that much conducive, then he may not decide to go to the supermarket. So there are different predictions we can think of in daily life, right? So that we can take into account, by which you can say is a supervised learning. That means by considering the data available to us, right, we can make ourselves on and take proper decision. So there are different, just like the spam filtering in emails we have. The time is very short. I'm not putting this examples much more. I'll go to the different unsupervised concept. So here unsupervised learning is a machine learning technique where you do not need to supervise the model. Instead, you need to allow the model to work on its own, discover the particular information. Basically, as all of you are talking about data analytics, whenever we are talking about machine learning, deep learning, we need to talk about the data. If the data representation scheme you are following, or if the data which is available to you is proper, then your model can work properly. Otherwise, your, whatever the model you take, it will definitely fail to give you a desired result. That's why data labeling is an important task in this kind of research. So labeling of the data is much important. In supervised learning, the main idea is to learn under supervision that we have already seen. But here, that means the supervision, the word supervision means is a targeted well. That means you have been given a target. That's the particular target you need to reach, right? So that is being supervised. But in case of unsupervised, you are not given with any target, but you need to find out a more accurate result. So that is called unsupervised part. Similarly, these are the example of unsupervised. Now here, different cartoon figures are available. You are going to classify them. How do you classify? So that means no two cartoons are having same features, or no two cartoons are, you can see in a visual clarity, you cannot match two cartoons having similarity, but still you need to classify them. How do you? So for that, you need to extract the features, you need to get to know which cartoon representing what, everything you need to label. So because these are the unlabeled data, you need to label them, then you need to process them, then you can separate them, or you can say, can classify them easily. So there are different research area, clustering is one of the area of unsupervised learning. Association rule is another area of unsupervised learning, right? Now coming to the reinforcement, right? Many of you have gone through the cluster level, there is a catalyst in chemistry, right? So catalyst is to give a backup, right? You can say it will just catalyze the process, right? So similarly, in reinforcement learning, there is an agent which is available during the process. So here, we are going to learn by interacting with the environment. The agent receives the reward by performing correctly, or penalties by performing incorrectly. So here, the agent is coming into picture, no other sense. The agent learns without any intervention by the human being which are available. So it is, you can say, it is a dynamic programming concept. That means, all of you know, whenever the train is moving, there are a lot of dynamic algorithm is coming up, because at real time, you need to check what is the signal, right? Whether the track is proper or not, right? Everything in a dynamic sense. That is called reinforcement learning, which is being guided by an agent. And that agent you need to develop. Nobody is going to give you. So that's why it is neither supervised nor unsupervised, but it is reinforced. So that means some agent is forcing to learn that way or a different other way. So here, just like a robot. So whenever you are going to develop a robot, that means the robot is an agent here, and the environment which is having a fire. So robot agent which is going to learn, but as there is a fire, we have to take the water into it, so that initially this particular second diagram, the robot is moving towards the fire where it is having certain damage. So it is going to get penalty, right? But next time is going to avoid that particular move, so that it can go to water and come back and put it onto the particular fire, so that it can get a particular reward. So here, this is a heat and trial method. Every time he has to learn something. It is not the case that penalty it is going to get. It is the case it is going to learn by self. That is the case of reinforcement learning. So there are different algorithms you can go for, which are available for research, right? We are using all such learning algorithms, different classifiers, right? Different reinforcement learning algorithm, Q-learning, SARSA learning, right? Unsupervised also available. Now, I'm going directly to the basics of CNN. I'm just avoiding this ANN, because in giving CNN, I'll be discussing what is CNN. Now, machine learning and this deep learning concept. See, deep learning, the word suggests deep. That means whenever we are processing a particular data, whether we are considering each and every aspect of features, every characteristic feature available in the data. If it is so, then we can say it is a deep learning. So that's why all deep learning models are more data hungry. Data hungry means they need more volume of data than the machine learning algorithm. So that's why these two are different in terms of the data requirement. So if the volume of data is very less, then it is not wise to go for deep learning concept. So nowadays, there are a lot of research people did, and they developed the model in such a manner that it can generate the data. That we say generative adversarial network. So here we can generate the, suppose you have S volume of data, and you can generate or you can create synthesized data, which can be useful for creating large volume of data for your research. That is also available using deep learning. So deep learning is an AI function that mimics the working of human brain in processing the data for use in detecting objects, recognizing speech, right, translating different languages, and obviously creating certain decision or predicting certain result. So deep learning is a class of machine learning, right? People initially understood machine learning and deep learning are different parts, right? But it's a class of machine learning algorithm that uses multiple layers, right? Which can extract different level of features. As I told, deep learning, that means it is going to at the deep level so that it can extract it. It is not going to skip any kind of features. It has to extract every possible feature of a particular data. See, features I mean, it is not only image data, it is also any varieties of data. So features are available. That it is going to start at this level. So deep learning and machine learning, I hope all of you easily categorize why we differ them. And there are different deep learning algorithms available. There are CNNs, LSTMs, RNNs, GANs, RBFNs. So my research team, they are working on this particular algorithm. We have already done a lot of research on this, and we are now developing a network fusion. That means we are combining different good behavior of this network or this network, and we are going to create a different network. This is going to definitely change the behavior of the result, right, or accuracy. So that is called network fusion. So there are a lot of applications so we can have in computer vision. Basically, in computer vision, I can say we can utilize the biomedical image processing, where you can localize the cancer cells. You can suppose say there is a very good research area which we are currently doing. Suppose somebody is having cancer and he is taking chemotherapy. Due to chemotherapy, the doctors are saying yes. You may require, he is analyzing the image, right, of the cancer, whatever the persons it is going to have, and he is suggesting you need to take this much chemotherapy, right, 2, 3, 4, like that. So have you thought of, due to this chemotherapy, that means some rays are falling on the particular cells, and it is going to kill that cell. It is not going to kill that only cells, but also some other cells surrounded to that cancer cell. So research is going on that how much, suppose say one chemotherapy is going to kill how much percent, that means the lifespan of the cancer cell is damaged, how much percent, or the good cells, right, which are not cancerous, how much percentage of the food cells are also damaged. So a lot of research are now going on. So that's a very good research dimension all of you can work on in your data stage. And there is a natural language processing, as I told, example of friends, whenever they are going to go for outing, right, and choosing the hotel, right, the natural language processing is going to play a vital role for the voice-assisted vehicles, right? So we are also working with this particular domain with Mercedes-Benz, because we are going to develop one machine learning model which is going to process the voice, right, of the driver or of the passengers and do certain tasks, desired tasks, right? That is also a very good area of this. So there are a lot of other things, but as the time, I think 15 minutes I have already crossed. I think the time is already over, right?
Yes, sir. Actually, we are the time is almost 2 hours, and we are at the end. And I just like to ask the participants. Hello. If they are having any questions, they can raise questions to the chat box.
They can ask. I can answer that.
Okay. So still, we do not get any question from the end. So to sum up the our webinar, as we have gathered lots of knowledge from the experts, so the deep learning is a subset of the artificial intelligence, and in particular, if you can say, it is the field of machine learning. So multi-layered artificial neural network, which actually carry out a range of different kind of application, like fraud detection, to speech recognition or the language translation. If we can say that this business domain, in a deep learning, improve the customer experience. Like, you know that Microsoft has and learning, and they are actually using a neural network to enhance and develop their system. And similarly, we have heard and we are familiar with the Microsoft application and Skype. So these are the compatible to the chatbot, and they are the only mid for the deep learning driven system. Similarly, both applications are capable of sharing queries. So similarly, Amazon, you know that the Alexa system or the Google are also, making the most deep learning possibilities. So Google has been using this system to improve YouTube video recommendation for a number of years, and as of now. And deep, and you can say the machine learning and the artificial neural network, they are also helping Google to improve their search engine and the optimized in the Android devices or any other platform. So if we can see the Google. Lots of applications are evolved, and our satellite data, cloud computing, deep learning. So this all are under the deep learning, how to identify how you can segment all the data from one point to another point. Okay. So this is about the deep learning concept, and the help of OpenCV. Basically, this open source computer vision library helps us to identify the lots of algorithms. Okay. The comprehensive set of both classes, or you can say the state of the art computer vision and machine learning algorithm. So I think get lots of new information with this webinar, and hope we arrange this kind of webinar in our future. So thank you all the participants, and specifically I just like to thank our president sir, our KC, our professor madam, and the faculty members, those who are indirectly or indirectly involved in this webinar. Okay, so I think, and I'm just using my mobile. A few times back, I got struck by the lightning and my laptop got a problem. Okay, not able to take all. Thank you.
Abhijit sir, your voice is breaking actually. we are not hearing properly. So so any question from any question from any participants, so we are able to ready to give the any answer without any fail. We are able to ready. Abhijit sir.
Okay. Hello, I'm yes sir, you are audible. Hello.
So before quitting the session, I would like to tell something.
Yes, please.
Abhijit sir, my voice is audible.
Yes, audible.
So any question, otherwise no question.
No, I think there is no question in the chat box, and we can quit, I think. Okay.
Okay, so actually, yes. Within a short interval of time, is not possible to show all these things, but in future, if you will get some time, definitely we will show you and more beautiful things. So first of all, again, giving thanks to you and director, sir, management, because you provided an opportunity to us for associating with you and your organization, and giving a thanks to all the participants. So everybody have participated, and I hope everybody listened our valuable session, and my special thanks also to my teammate Rashmi and Dr. Bunil. So overall, Abhijit sir, thank you to all of you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Abhijit.
Thank you, Bunil sir. We'll talk later on, because there is lot of problem I have faced today. Okay. Yes. Sure. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.